larval forms of crustaceans. Crustaceans show both direct and indirect development. In direct development, like in palemon and crayfish, the adult is attained by progressive growth and differentiation of the embryo so that the newly hatched young resembles the parents in general structure. In indirect development, there is larval stage which differs from the adult in many features and acquires adulthood through metamorphosis. Many of the crustaceans undergo indirect development involving a wide variety of larval forms. Of these, three main larval forms are Nauplius, Zoea and Megalopa. Intermediate stages receive different names like Metanauplius, Cypris and Protozoea. Modified and distinct forms of Zoea are given special designation like Mysis of lobsters, Philostoma of the spiny lobster and Alima of squilla. Let's start by looking at each one of them independently. The first is the Nauplius. Nauplius is characteristic of the class Crustaceae. It is the simplest and commonest type of larva found in most crustaceans and a few Malacostracans. When development proceeds through many larval forms, the Nauplius is the earliest and the basic larval form. The body is minute with three indistinct regions, a median eye, often referred to as the Nauplius eye, three pairs of jointed appendages, the uranimus antennules, they act as the balancing organ, the biramus antennae, which is the principal locomotor organ, and mandibles, which along with the antennae may share the function of food collection. In branchiopods, the Nauplius develops straight away into the adult, but in most other crustaceans, it may give rise to other intermediate larval forms like the Metanauplius, Protozoea, Zoea, Mysis, Metanauplius. Metanauplius is the later Nauplius instar and results by the process of molting and growth. Its body is divisible into a broad cephalothorax and an elongated abdomen, terminating into a pair of caudal forks. Besides the three pairs of Nauplii appendages, it also bears rudiments of four pairs of appendages, which are two pairs of maxillae and two pairs of maxillipedes of the adults. Some decapods and stomapods and other nostricans like apus begin their life history with the free-swimming Metanauplius larva. Protozoea. In case of marine prawns like Pinnaeus and some decapods, the earliest Nauplius by growth and molting develops into the Protozoea larva. Its body is divisible into a broad segmented cephalothorax covered with a small carapace and a slender abdomen which is unsegmented and bears no appendages, terminating in a forked telson. There is a single median Nauplius eye and the appendages comprise of the antennules, antennae, mouthparts and first and second maxillipedes. The Protozoea later modifies into the Zoea larva. Zoea. In almost all marine decapods, except the pinnaeids, hatching takes place at the Zoea stage, as in true crabs. Zoea has a broad cephalothorax and a curved abdomen which assists in swimming and is provided with a forked telson. Helmet-like carapace bears two long spines, a median dorsal and a median rostrum, two lateral spines. A pair of large stalked movable compound eyes are also present. In addition to the protozoeal appendages, there appear rudiments of the thoracic appendages of adults. Biramus maxillipedes are used for swimming. Cypris. Biramus maxillipedes are used for swimming. Cypris. The Cirripediae, like Lepas and Sacculina, have a Nauplius larva passing into the Cypris stage. In this form, the body and appendages are enclosed within a bivalved shell provided with adductor muscles as seen in the adult Cypris. Its modified antennules have cement glands at their base. All other cephalic appendages with a compound eye except antennae are present. 6 pairs of biramus thoracic limbs are formed. It has an abdomen with 4 to 5 segments. Mysis or cygopod. In pinnated decapods like Pinnaeus and lobster zoea get modified into mysis larva. It bears 13 pairs of appendages and resembles the adult mysis. It has 5 pairs of posterior biramus thoracic appendages. Abdomen is posterior, similar to that of the adult, with 5 pairs of biramus pleopods and a pair of uropods and a telson. In some lobsters, mysis marks the beginning of the life history as the nauplius and zoea are passed within the egg, but at the same time it marks the end of the life history of a prawn. Megalopa. In Brachyurian decapods or true crabs, zoea metamorphoses into the megalopa larva. It resembles to some extent the adult crab and possesses all 13 pairs of appendages. The abdomen bears 6 pairs of pleopods and is placed straight in line with the cephalothorax. In crab, the nauplii stage is passed within the egg, which then hatches into the zoea. By molting, it then forms the megalopa and gets metamorphosed into an adult. In herbert crabs, the glaucothea corresponds to a megalopa with symmetrical abdomen and swimming pleopods. Philosoma. The larva of Palinurus, the spiny crab or rock lobster, is called philosoma or glass crab. It is a modified mysis stage. It is remarkably large, flattened, leaf-like, delicate and glassy. The body is distinguished into a head, a transparent thorax and abdomen. The eyes are compound and stalked. Out of 6 pairs of thoracic appendages, the first or maxillipedes are rudimentary. The second are uniramus, third well-formed biramus succeeded by the rest. Fourth, fifth and sixth pair of long biramus legs. A segmented but limbless abdomen is present. Before reaching the adult stage, it undergoes several moltings. The Alima larva. It is a modified form of zoea found in some malacostracans like squilla, which hatch from the egg. It is a pelagic form with glassy transparency, having a slender body. It bears short and broad carapace. It has all the cephalic appendages but only first 2 thoracic ones. A 6-segmented abdomen with 4 or 5 pairs of pleopods can be seen. It differs from zoea in having a well-formed second maxillipedes and the armature of the telson.